Hello and welcome to Rat Tail. I am your friend Adrian. Yeah, as much as I look over here, look at the door, look at the ceiling, y'all, Chris isn't coming. Unfortunately, this week, Chris is on vacation. He is out of town, and it landed right when I returned from my last two concerts. So this week, you are stuck with me, you all. And if you're wondering what you're stuck here doing, let me tell you a little bit about our channel. Rat Tail is a YouTube channel that reacts to, commentates, loves on all things New Kids on the Block. And yeah, we're happy you're here. If you're a first-time subscriber, please make sure you hit that subscribe button. And while you do that, all our returning family is going to get some eye candy here. Man, Chris is missing out. I think I'm choosing that one on purpose because Chris isn't here. If you're a blockhead like myself, or even if you're not a blockhead, that's usually our friend Chris's department. Everybody is welcome here. Everybody is welcome here. See, I got Danny to help us out. Oh, sorry. This was left over from our meet and greet. This is not Joey. It's not Joey anymore. If you haven't checked out our meet and greet episode, you need to do that now because I know there's still some more shows. So if you have a meet and greet later on in the tour, check that out. Some really great tips. But instead of Chris being here, I got Danny. You know, I'm a Danny girl. So Danny's going to fill in. And of course, we have John, our good friend John. And again, if you're like, what the fuck, that's Stone Cold Steve Austin, check out our meet and greet episode. This is not Stone Cold Steve Austin. This is John Knight. And you'll know why when you check out that episode. So those are our friends that are going to sit in for Chris. John's going to sit on Danny's lap, which is really fun. So today's episode, Chris had a chance to debrief with you all. And oh my gosh, I had so much fun playing that match game. So if you haven't checked out part one, do that first. Come back. This is part two. I'm going to be debriefing you on my experience throughout the Mixtape 2022 tour. And we have one more episode, which is going to be out next week. And I'm so excited for you to see that because it's going to bring it all together in really the best way possible. So before I just go straight into story time, I got to be really honest. A lot of people talk about it, and I've like heard rumblings of it before this tour started, and I didn't quite get it, but now I get it. And what I'm talking about, and this is going to be the theme of the episode, is PCD, post-concert depression. It is real, y'all. It is real. And for someone that is emotionally tapped in to emotions and feelings, I found myself crying on the airplane ride home from my last show, and I couldn't believe it. But it's real, y'all. I am so sad that my concert tour experience for the year is over, and I'm feeling it. So, in true Hollywood fashion, I have brought relief. I have brought things to make me feel better. So I got to share that real quick. So the first thing is my favorite chips. It's the Hawaiian Luau Barbecue. They are so good. They are sweet and spicy. Because it's time to just veg out. I'm in my Nanook sweatsuit. I have the pants on. I just feel like vegging out because I'm fucking sad. Oh, and then I got my chocolate peanut butter ice cream, which is the Signature Select Safeway brand. Now, here's the thing about ice cream. This is what's comforting me. And the last thing, I know, you know, I want to know in the comments how you feel about this comfort food, because it's literally one of my favorites, and they've been sold out at my grocery store every week for the last 2 months because I don't know. You know, there's all the shortages and stuff. But the powdered donuts, the white powdered donuts, these are the best comfort food. And real good. And they're always sold out. And finally, I think it was fate because grocery store knew I was filming today. Anyway, shot time. Here at Rat Tail, we take a shot before every episode. Oh, and look at my shot bottle. Happy Pride. It's not Pride Month when this comes out, but it is still Pride Month when I'm filming. So here's my Pride Absolute. Love the bottle. Love Pride. Cheers. If you're going through PCD with me, God bless you. If you are not going through PCD, but you will, save this and come back and let's get through it together. And if you haven't been able to catch a tour, just come be with me because I'm excited to share about my adventures. So cheers to you all. Love you. Let's do this. Okay. Oh my gosh, the ice cream is covering Danny and John. That's not okay. So I'm excited to share with you my adventures. Get comfy. Get ready. Get your own comfort food. Get your own comfort alcohol. And let's talk about Mixtape Tour 2022, the Adrian experience. So, real quick, I'm going to start logistically from the first concert to my last concert. But you are going to notice a gap because there are two shows in my journey, specifically the San Jose and Sacramento show. And those shows are the ones that Chris and I did together. Those were the Rat Tail shows. And boy, can I fucking tell you, they were magic. And if you're thinking about what is part three, because this is a three-part series, we're thinking that's part three. So that's when you're going to get to hear about those shows. We were so blessed by the guys in the band, by the people that we were able to party with. Life was so good during those two shows. I basically did all of the California shows. We did a Rat Tail California tour. And then I did two shows in the Midwest. I did the second night of Chicago and the Mount Pleasant Soaring Eagles show. So we're going to start off with my friends, Rebecca and Chrissy, picking my ass up. They drove from Sacramento down to San Jose to pick me up, and we drove all the way to San Diego. And San Diego was our first show. I was so excited, but I was nervous the entire day before that we were driving down, because not only was this my first show, this was also my first meet and greet. And so I'm going to be sharing some pictures as we go of the experience. Fun drive there. I love Chrissy and Rebecca. Amazing blockhead friends that I have made. I'm so lucky to have them. And yeah, it was fun doing the road trip. It, you know, it's a long drive from the Bay Area to San Diego, but we made it safe and sound. And we spent the night beforehand. And then the next day it was concert day. And I was so excited. I was so nervous. I will say I was so nervous a million times this video because I spent half of this tour being nervous as fuck. I was with good friends, which was amazing. We go to the arena in San Diego. It's on the San Diego State campus, I believe. I had my first meet and greet and I was really excited because me and my friend Tracy, we got matching t-shirts and I love, it's one of my favorite things to see on social media is everybody's outfits and everybody's t-shirts. These t-shirts were fucking amazing because these t-shirts were a song pun and Tracy's brother used to sing this when she was little, but instead of my favorite girl, he would sing my favorite squirrel. And so we made t-shirts that said my favorite squirrel. And mine, of course, said Danny, and Tracy, who's a Donnie Danny girl, hers said Donnie. And so these squirrels on the t-shirts were Danny and Donnie, and it was just, it was so cute. My first meet and greet at the San Diego show was really an experience. And I'm gonna be really, really honest about my experience. It did not go the way I wanted it to go. So hands up if you've ever had a meet and greet and have had that experience. And I think what happened is what happens to a lot of us who have a meet and greet for the first time. We think that it's going to produce some type of amazing event that's going to change or alter the course of our lives. When in actuality, it really is only like a minute and 30 second experience, and you really only have like 10 seconds with each guy. It's super quick. It's super worth it, but it's super quick. And what happened to me is I think what has happened to some of us before. So before I tell this story, I absolutely will not tolerate any hate towards Danny or towards my picture mate with Danny. But I also want to be honest. What happened is I had the shirt with Danny and I walked into the line, and you know Danny is first in line to greet everybody, which is a great choice because I think Danny is really good at it. And Tracy was on the other side of me because she was with Donnie and I was with Danny. We both had our t-shirts. And I go up to Danny and I immediately like open up my jacket and I'll look a flasher. I wouldn't do that, but I had my shirt under. And I was like, Danny, look at my shirt. It's you. And he starts looking at it and he's about to say something. But then out of the corner of his eye, he sees the woman who is also standing on the other side. Now, I don't know the woman very much that I was standing next to. I knew her because she sold me my ticket. And we had just kind of had some small talk beforehand. I didn't know her very well. But apparently her and Danny are friends. And so before he could say anything to me, he saw her and was like, oh my God, I'm so excited to see you. And like gave her a big hug and was very clearly very excited to see her. And I was like crickets. I was like, I'm Adrian from Reddale. I'm a Danny girl. It was bad. Like internally, I was like, oh, this is horrible. But then after the picture gets taken, I get shuffled into Donnie. And Donnie swoops in, saves the day, and he's like, get over here. And he pulls Tracy and I over to take a separate picture of him flanked by the My Favorite Squirrel Girls. So that was a pretty amazing experience. And then went through the line and said hello to the guys. And before I knew it, it was done. And yeah, it's like just like that, it was done. I will say, like, in that moment, I learned a big lesson about meet and greets. I learned that you gotta keep your expectations low and you gotta let the magic come to you. And I say that because later on in the tour, I had plenty of time to connect with Danny, and I'll share that in a little bit. And I also realized that, like, if you're in a band and you've had fans that have been with you for years and years and years, and you see one of them that you are connected with, that is well connected with the band and someone who has been a fan for a long time, you absolutely should have the space to be excited and to get to say hello and have time with them. So I'm definitely on that level with it, but it just was a good learning experience for me. So for my first meet and greet, it was a great lesson to be learned. And I know I'm showing pictures as we go. I want to thank everybody that was with me. The show was fucking amazing. What was exciting about San Diego is I was in the pit, which was super exciting. This show is amazing. And if you've been to one, you know it. And if you haven't, get ready. So after San Diego, we were right on our way, and our next show was Los Angeles. Now, the LA show, we had nosebleed seats, And I went again with my friends, Rebecca and Chrissy, and we met a bunch of our other friends there. So throughout this journey, we had hooked up with friends from Europe, from Australia. We met with Vanessa from NKOTB Polls. We met Nikki, we met Jenny from Australia. I mean, we just met so many of the friends we've met at Rat Tail and the friends we met through Rebecca and Chrissy. It was so fucking fun to get to see everybody and to do each of these shows with them. So we get to LA. What's really exciting about LA is we're literally in the arena, Crypto Arena, and on our way up the escalator to our nosebleed seats, we get stopped by a ticket person who's like, hey, we have some open seats at the bottom of the bottom section. Do you want them? And we were like, fuck yeah. So we get upgraded to like the very row above the floor, right behind the sound booth. Sound booth was not blocking us, with a direct view of the B stage. Fucking fantastic. I know I'm showing you pictures here. It was another incredible show. Incredible energy. Amazing. Didn't have a meet and greet that time, which actually was good because I could take some breaths, shake off that first meet and greet. And we just had the time of our lives. And afterwards, as we exit crypto.com arena, two things happened. One, I lost Flat Chris, so I didn't share with you all, but through the California tour, for the shows that Chris was not at, I made this very cute printed out Chris and put him on a popsicle stick and carried him around to each of the concerts. Please follow us on Instagram and Twitter because that is where you will see most of the photos. And I lost his ass. It was just like dancing around too much or something. So that was a major sad point. Ugh. But as we exit the arena and as we're waiting to go to our friend's hotel room before we drive back to our own, we found this saxophonist, this artist on the corner playing out loud, and he starts playing New Kids on the Block songs. Jesus Christ. It was magic. And for literally a half hour, we just sat there on the corner singing every song at the top of our lungs with this saxophone. And y'all, wanna know what song he played? You guessed it. He played This One's for the Motherfucking Children.
We played
People are happy and many people are sad.
And I literally had a transcendental experience. Like, I looked up at the sky and I was like, the universe is aligning because this is magic. And we just sang at the top of our lungs. It was incredible. Just one of the many magical moments. After Los Angeles, the very next day, we have our Anaheim show. Now, our Anaheim show was the first night I actually got to party, as in shots in the hotel room. We had friends join us. You're gonna see images right here. We played club. Now, if you don't know what club is, I'm gonna let you in on a secret. I had my friend Susanna, she bought me a disco light. Basically what club is where you take a hotel room, you put on a disco light, and you and your friends just play the nastiest music and you go fucking crazy. And by nasty, I mean like sexy ass music. Like, you become your sexiest self and you just dance in club. We did it before the show and it was lit. Went to the Anaheim show, we sat at the very top, and it was still magic. Still magic up at the very top. We got to see Elle's proposal, and just as a little preview, I think we're gonna hear from Elle a little bit later this month. Elle is a longtime New Kids on the Block fan, and her fiance proposed to her after California Love. It was fucking amazing. Oh, it was such a good show. And it was finally good to actually get to see it from the nosebleeds, because it's cool to get to see it from that vantage point. It's a whole different experience, and it's amazing. All right, so I think, y'all, I'm gonna take a little PCD break, because I feel the emotions becoming overwhelming. So let's just take a break.
There's always some reason to feel not good enough, and it's hard at the end of the day. I need some distraction. Oh,
I'm back. But y'all, I usually don't drink alone. This is an experience. Oh God. All right, I'm back. Hopefully we're shaking it off a little bit. The PCD, hopefully we're shaking it off, because I have more to tell you. So after that, after Anaheim, we drove our asses home. And by we drove our asses home, Chrissy drove Rebecca and I home, which I'm so grateful for. And we have a day off. And so we took that day off, and then we had Fresno. Now, what's exciting about this day off is, in the meantime, we had some other friends fly into the Bay Area because they were getting ready to go to the San Jose Sacramento shows. And one of my friends, Naomi, from Dope Nostalgia Podcast, flew in, and she got her ass down to San Jose so I could pick her up and take her to the Fresno show. She got bar stools in Fresno. I did not have bar stools, but I had fucking fantastic seats. I forget where they were, but they were right by the Jordan box for tonight. So, yeah. It was fucking so fun. Y'all, Fresno is known as like the armpit of California, but Fresno showed up. I don't know if it was the arena, which was also at the Fresno State campus. Go Bulldogs. But dude, the crowd was lit in Fresno. And what was exciting is we also had matching coordinated outfits again, just like San Diego. So just like San Diego, how my friend Tracy and I dressed in my favorite squirrel, this show, my friends Chrissy, Rebecca, and Jenny, JK's Mental Shot on Instagram, we all wore our Jordan Idol shirts. Now, I know you're seeing them right here, but they are so cute. They have Billy Idol on them, and they did their cricket magic. And instead of Billy, they put Jordan Idol. And then on the back, they had team what their favorite dance move was. So you have team oink, team body roll with a thrust, team fuck the floor, and I was team classic body roll, of course. But oh my God, how fucking cute! And that was also the day that we carried on the tradition of the meow meow ears. You will see me wearing meow meow ears throughout the footage of me on the tour. Please follow meow meow NKOTB on Instagram. You will see pictures from every single city of people wearing meow meow ears. It's just our group of friends just sharing the love. And what's really exciting is the guys know about us. Both Joey and Donnie have commented about seeing the ears from stage. And Donnie also currently has a pair of his own. And so Fresno was the last show in California. And what I want to end that with is the four shows in California and the one meet and greet was really my first experience with NKOTB touring as an adult. It was also an experience that I had to do without Chris because Chris was not able to join me until San Jose and Sacramento. And what I quickly realized as quickly as San Diego is that there are so many of you out there that I've gotten to know over social media and that have become my friends. I'm like two shots in. But it just was amazing to have so many of you come up and say hello, even though Chris wasn't with me. And so just like the power of this family of everybody that watches, I got to meet so many of you that I've been wanting to meet for so long. That mixed with the five guys and this fucking terrific tour, just some of the happiest moments I've had in such a long time. And so thank you to everybody, but we still have more. Okay, I'm back and the California sun is in my face. I don't have an Olight because it's at Chris's house. This is the most unprofessional fucking video ever made. Sorry, y'all. Sorry, but not sorry. I'm going for another shot. Here's to Donnie, Danny, Jordan, Johnny, and Joey. I just called John Johnny. He's never called Johnny. So let me try that again. This is to our five favorite guys, Donnie, Danny, Joe, John, and Jordan. Love you. And thank you for this fucking terrific tour. Cheers. Maybe a chip will help. Or donut. I gotta try to beat the sunlight because I don't have an Olight. This is a mess. Chris, come help me. So after the Fresno show, we had the San Jose Sacramento shows. And as I told you before, I am not spilling any of those details because you have to come back next week. Those details are amazing. Like, it's my cat's tail. She says hello. My cat Beatrice is saying hello. Those details are not to miss because I guarantee it was fucking magic. We are blessed. It was amazing. So San Jose happens, then Sacramento happens. And then I come home for 2 weeks. And then I'm flying my ass to Michigan. Now, why am I flying my ass to Michigan? Well, I'm flying my ass to Michigan because I have family in Michigan. My dad and my sister, my brother-in-law, and my stepmom, and my six nieces and nephews live in Michigan. So I thought, why not combine my summer trip to see them with concerts that are happening out there? And so I flew out to Michigan, which allowed me to go to Chicago Night 2 and Mount Pleasant Soaring Eagle. So let's start off with Chicago. I get to Chicago and thankfully, months ago, my angel blockhead, tailgate queen Michelle, was able to snag me a Dine with Danny ticket. Now, if you don't know what Dine with Danny is, Dine with Danny is an event that is held by Remember Betty. Remember Betty is Danny's foundation, Danny and his brothers and sisters, they have a foundation in honor of his mother, Betty, who unfortunately passed away from breast cancer. And so this is an amazing foundation. I love this foundation. It raises money for expenses incurred for breast cancer patients and helps them with everything from gas, rent, food, all that super important stuff that we might not think about when it comes to being a cancer patient. Amazing. Now, these tickets were a hot item. If you tried to get them, you know what I was talking about. My angel friend, Michelle, came in, got me a ticket. Love you, friend. She knew I was Danny girl. Love you, Danny. And got me a ticket. Now, this event, we got there, was so well done, was so well executed. The decor was top notch. And we got to have another meet and greet one-on-one with Danny, which is fucking fantastic. Okay, so you're probably seeing a lot more eye contact, and this is why Chris has to be here, because he would have been like, Adrian, you're filming with the camera lens on the wrong end, and they're not gonna get to see any eye contact. So I'm sorry, y'all just went 30 minutes without me having any eye contact. Ugh. Chris, come back soon. Oh, I'm starting to feel it, y'all. This is also why you don't get drunk alone, because this is weird. Anyway, Dine with Danny, such an amazing event. And I got to see my friend Danny Wood. And what was so exciting is when we had our picture taken, he was so sweet. I came up and he was like, where's your partner in crime, Chris? And I was like, oh, he's not here. And then we took two of the goofiest ass pictures ever. Look at these fucking pictures. Jesus fucking Christ. I look like I, maybe there still is no eye contact. I can't tell. Y'all, I'm sorry. Anyway, they took these goofy ass pictures of me and Danny. But then Danny came over. He was going like, you know, like at a wedding, like table by table. And when he came to our table, I got to chat him up a little bit, which was so fun. Actually, Chris just sent me a post. That's so funny. It's weird. Chris just sent me a post while this is filming. I gotta tell this story because otherwise this is gonna be a 40. Oh my God, I think it's back upside down. Oh my God, y'all. I just filmed upside down. Y'all, I don't know what to do. I'm drunk, alone, and without our tech expert. So y'all are not gonna get any eye contact this video because I don't know how to fix it. And y'all just watch this upside down. Whatever. Y'all are just like, Adrian's losing it. Well, guess what? I am. Okay. So, Danny came over, and guess what? I asked him if he would FaceTime Chris on my phone, and he FaceTimed Chris. Okay, so I gotta get going, because otherwise this is gonna be a 50-minute episode. Okay, so after dying with Danny, which was amazing, I got to meet Bethany, I got to meet Brett, some of his siblings. Amazing job, Remember Betty United. Thank you for having me. It was so well done. What a great way to start. And then directly we go to VIP. Now VIP, I had Party Pit VIP because I was in the Party Pit. So much fun. Now, if I thought the first four shows of California were awesome, with getting to meet y'all, Chicago was lit. I got to see so many of you. Pictures are flowing right here as I talk. Got to meet, oh, I totally forgot one whole event. Before the Dine with Danny event, I went to the Walk of Fame event at the Wahlburgers in St. Charles, because I was staying with my angel blockhead Michelle in St. Charles, and we went to the Walk of Fame event. Now, that was okay. We weren't there in enough time to get seats where we could see anything. So I just fucked around in the back and danced to the music. And if you follow us on Insta, you saw my lives. You saw my footage. It was fun, but we didn't really get to see the guys. Whatever. It was still fun. I still got to see so many of you. That was the fun part. Like, okay, I love our five guys, but this is really about you all. And loving you guys. I love you guys as much as I love our five guys. The meet and greet, it was so lovely to meet so many of you. And then the concert that night was lit. I was lit in the pit. I was hanging out with my friends. Honestly, that was the first night I was legitimately drunk at a concert. We were slamming down doubles. It was fucking fantastic. It was my second pit. Got so much fun interaction with the guys. Like, hold up. I forgot to mention these t-shirts. They are so cute. And as you can see, they are the five steps. I got them from Christina's Custom Cuts. Cutest t-shirts ever. And of course, because I was with Jonathan, mine says,
I am here for step 5. And of course, you know, it says, don't you know that the time is right? Yes.
So much fun. This tour is so much fun. Get tickets if you haven't gotten them yet. Chicago, the crowd. I thought West Coast crowds were it. No, we got work to do. This Chicago crowd was loud and proud. I'm pouring another shot. I don't know why. Maybe because I said proud. I'm not going to take it right now. Hold on. So that show was fucking amazing. I'm posting pictures as I talk of so many of you. Love you guys. It was so amazing to get to meet you. And then I went back to my dad's house for about a week until the Soaring Eagle show. And the Soaring Eagle show was amazing. Now, one of the reasons, the first reason it was amazing is I got to go with my sister. And that was really, really special. I love you, Julia. Now, I decided to take my sister to the show because my sister is a first-year teacher and just got done with her first year of teaching. Teaching right now is hard, y'all. If you don't know, figure it out. So it was the perfect way. The concert was like the day after her last day of teaching. And my stepmom and dad got us a room at the casino. It was amazing. So we went and the meet and greet was so much fun. Now, oh my gosh, hold on. I got to show you something. It's Night Slugger Beer. My God. Because after the meet and greet, my angel friend, Nicole, so many angel blockheads, trust me, we will honor you soon, got me into the Slugger Lounge. Dude, y'all, Slugger Lounge is fucking lit. And if you haven't gone, you need to buy tickets to go. If you're like, I've been wondering if it's worth going, get your ticket. It's so much fucking fun. These guys are lit. They're playing good music. You're going to have a good time. It's kid friendly. Saw a bunch of kids. There's nothing I wouldn't want a kid of mine to see. It was so fun. So do it. Buy the tickets. What was so cool about Barstools is that it was my last show. And Soaring Eagle is an outdoor venue, y'all. So I finally got to see the tour outdoors. Now, the show was lit. Got to meet so many of you again. Got to hang out with some amazing friends at the Barstools. But yeah, show was lit. They were very hot in the beginning, but why wouldn't you be? Still performed amazingly. And I also got a lot of really special moments with them on stage. These guys put on a fantastic show. And if you pay the money to be at Barstools, if you pay the money to be on the floor, a lot of times you're gonna get so many interactions. They interact, they have fun with you. It's fucking fantastic. And it was amazing. And then we spent the night and we went home. So that's it. This is also one of my first times getting drunk on my own. You guys were absolutely no help. Okay, so I just have some final words. And I already cried once. I'm gonna cry again. Because, like, I'm not sure that this is really PCD, but I'm gonna restate it as PCG. I'm gonna cry again. So instead of post-concert depression, I'm gonna call it post-concert gratitude, because I feel like that's something Donnie would say. Literally the last month and a half of my life has been so magical. And given where we're at with everything happening and with the really hard couple years that we have all had, I am so grateful to have gotten to experience this amazing community. I just want you all to know how much you mean to me And for every picture I have shared, and for every picture I don't have that I haven't shared yet, each time I've gotten to talk to you has meant so much to me. Because Chris and I are just drunk. This is because I'm drunk and grateful. Chris and I spend so much time filming in front of a camera to nobody. And I know you all watch, but it's not like we get to see you in person. For me, that is the biggest gift. I'm so grateful for you all. I love you. Chris loves you. And I want to thank you, and I want to thank John, Joey, Jordan, Donnie, and Danny for one of the hottest tours I've ever seen. And I've seen a lot of concerts. I love you guys. And I'm going to go ahead and end with the most dramatic, the most tear-worthy video possible of all the video footage I have left from my 6 shows without Chris. I love you guys. Subscribe. I promise the next episode is going to be a lot more upbeat, and I promise I'll be able to make eye contact in the camera because Chris will be there. And I love you guys. And happy PCD, PCG. See you next week.
Take my